The pharmaceutical index, we spoke about Dr. Reddy's and Aurobindo Pharma. Now, Glenmark Pharma joins the pack. That one's lower by about 0.7%. But remember, the Nifty as well as the Nifty mid-cap index is high by 2-3%. So we have Glenmark Pharma, the lows of the day, and Cadila also seeing a bit of a sell-off. But talking about sell-off, Spencer's Retail, that's the one that should come up for you. A sharp knock of close to around 7% on that stock. Remember, on Friday, we saw a big up move on Spencer's Retail on the news that they've gone ahead and acquired Nature Basket from Godrej for about 300 crore rupees. Some more data suggests that maybe that that deal could be margin dilutive, return ratio dilutive for the company as well, because going through some numbers of Godrej Nature's Basket, over the last 10 years, Nigel, they have 350 crores of accumulated losses. Last year itself, they had losses of close to around 60, 62 crore odd rupees. So they're paying 1x sales, which is the same as the valuation at which Spencer's Retail trades. But for a loss-making company, growth rate has been much lower than what Spencer's Retail has been. And while it does give them access to a good brand and, you know, access to markets in the West and the South, but over the last 5 years, their sales growth has been much lower than Spencer's, which itself was among the lowest in the industry.
All right. Good point, Mangalam, you're making. You know, and besides that stock, by the way, I enjoy their service, by the way. Okay. but from a stock market point of view, clearly they've not taken it well. That's why the stock is, you know, is lower. But Mangalam, I think, you know, I've not gone to fill gas or petrol. You know, some of these OMCs, they're moving higher.
Right.
Maybe, in fact, you know, now that the election's out of the way, maybe, in fact, we'll go ahead and we'll see those increases, because HPCL is now up 8%. BPCL has moved to the high point of the day, and IOC as well is moving higher. So maybe, you know, we get back to those price hikes on schedule basis, I'm guessing.
Absolutely. A lot of people are saying that elections was a bit of an overhang. So let's see how that comes about. So we'll keep an eye out on that. HPCL, BPCL, of course, also report their numbers. So the street will be keeping an eye out on that. Talking about numbers, it was a weak quarter from Corporation Bank as far as their numbers are concerned, because they reported the highest ever quarterly loss. We have the MD and CEO, Ms. P.V. Bharati, who joins us now for detailing those numbers. Thanks a lot for speaking to us. Did you make higher provisions in this quarter to come out of the PCA framework?
Yes, that has been a specific thing. No, the government has infused the capital, right? 9,086, when they have infused, this is a specific purpose that our NPA should be less than 6% and we should come out of PCA.
All right, ma'am. You now have PCR of around 100% on your NCLT list. What kind of recovery do you expect over there in the coming fiscal, that's FY20?
See, FY20 in NCLT 1 and 2, we have got, in NCLT 1, we have got 11 accounts, and in NCLT 2, we are having 20. So, we are expecting around 2,000 crores of recovery from the NCLT 1 and 2 accounts.
All right. And how about slippages? How were they placed in the fourth quarter, and how does that compare to the third quarter?
Yeah, it is 6,282 is my total slippage for the year.
What about for the quarter? What is the slippage number?
For the quarter, it is around 1,200 crores.
All right. 6,000 crore plus for the year, 1,200 for the quarter. And despite a slight increase in your loan growth, your yields are under tremendous pressure. Why is that?
See, actually, yields is good. My yield on advances has been around 9.06. My pressure on interest, if you see, it is because of my investments. We have had a loss of around 700 crores on our investments. Interest on investments, because we have reduced our investments, our investment income has reduced by around 700. It was around 800 crores last year. The total interest on investments was 800 crores. This year, we have got a loss of 85 crores. So that 770 crores is showing as a loss in income. But in reality, my yield on advances was 9.06%.
Ms. Bharati, if you could tell us, what was your NIMs, your net interest margins in quarter four, and if you compare it on a sequential basis? And more importantly, what is your guidance of the NIMs for FY20?
Yeah, my net interest margin has actually improved to 3.05. And it was around 2.32 in the earlier quarter. And we look forward that it will be around 3% in the coming quarters also.
All right. And if you could give us your guidance for loan growth for the next fiscal.
Yes. Loan growth, as you know, we are still on a conservative note, I would say. But we have forecasted around a 7% growth in our loan book.
Okay, 7% growth in terms of loan book. What about, you know, but one important factor is these days ratings, they don't matter much. Agencies, they downgrade a rating to a BBB overnight as well. The big point is, what is the exposure to DHFL, Jet Airways, the ADAG group, or any other stressed account? Basically, ma'am, what we're trying to understand is, what is your watch list?
Yeah, my watch list doesn't have, see, I don't have exposure in Jet Airways. Okay, I have an exposure in ADAG group. I have got around 12 accounts, 1,655 crores, out of which around 600 crores have already been classified as NPA. In DHFL, I have got only a small exposure of around 633 crores. Okay, and ILFS, NPFC per se, I don't have an exposure. My total ILFS exposure was around 751, out of which 350 has already been classified as NPA. So if you talk about, yes, when I talk about AAA, AA, this could be the thing. But what we are trying to do is, we are trying a very cautious approach and we are going for working capital funding and short-term funding. And we have lines of credit which have been sanctioned to these bigger corporates. So as and when they need the short-term WCDL, they will be availing it from us. So we have been ensuring that the portfolio is continuously churned. We are not taking any long-term exposures, you know, like infra exposures, none of the infra exposures are really going, because that is really long term. So under AAA, AA also, we are taking short term, like a 6 month WCDL or a 3 month WCDL, which is actually helping me to churn my portfolio and also get an yield.
All right, thank you so much, ma'am, for giving us all those details with the granularity. When, just before we let you go, if you could tell us what your capital requirement for FY20 would be.
See, as of now, my capital adequacy stands at 12.30%. And even my CET1 is very comfortable. So going forward, I won't need an additional capital, but we'll be raising around 2,000 crores because we have to. We plan to raise around 2,000 crores between Q2 and Q3 to augment our growth.
Okay. All right.